There lies a dark reality behind the smiles of Gaza's children. Most of them are severely traumatized by war. It's been 1 month since Israel's last assault on the besieged Gaza Strip, and the nightmare still lives on for a majority of Gaza's most vulnerable population. This is the second time Mohammed had to be hospitalized.
Last month, he was playing in the farmland near his home when shrapnel from an Israeli missile ripped into his legs. His mother took him home to recover. Days later, she was forced to bring him back to the hospital. Isra was at the top of her class before a bomb blasted through her house last month. She was thrown 3 stories down, fracturing her pelvis, causing internal bleeding and brain injury. Miraculously, she survived, but she hasn't spoken since.
وهي البنت طلعوها من يوم الخميس من العناية بس البنت ما انت شايفاها مرخرخة بتمشيش وبعدين بتتحركش وبعدين بتتكلمش هي حالتها يعني هي زي ما انت شايفها بتتكلمش بفتح عينيها بس بتتكلمش بالمرة.
The children are not the only ones who have been affected. Grieving parents are struggling to cope with the psychological isolation of their surviving children.
كانت بنت حلوة كويسة حلوة تحب الحياة
18-year-old Yusra was killed by her mother's side, leaving behind 3 young brothers. Over half of Gaza's 1.7 million Palestinians are under the age of 18. A study conducted by UNICEF released earlier this month found that 92% of children in Gaza are afraid of loud sounds. Close to 70% reported constant nightmares. 80% reported bedwetting and night trembling. Other behavioral traits include depression, social isolation, and aggression. 4 years ago, Palestinian and international schools were bombed during Israel's cast lead. During its recent attack, Israeli bombs partially or completely damaged over 100 schools.
This is what's left of the Ministry of Interior. And while this is a government building operated by Hamas, it's literally surrounded by schools. On this side, you have one of UNRWA's schools belonging to the United Nations. This is a boys' elementary school, and you can see parts of it have been destroyed, so much so that classes there had to be canceled and the students had to be transferred to another school. On the opposite side of the UNRWA school, you have a government-operated school, and the 1,000 students who were attending this facility have now been forced to go to the one right behind it. Counselors at that school say they're overwhelmed with students who are coming to school with psychological trauma as a result of Israel's last bombardment.
There, at the Umm al-Qura school, located 100 meters away from the destroyed Interior Ministry, it seems like just another school day. But teachers and school counselors describe an environment where a majority of their pupils are constantly disturbed by their war experiences. Education seems far from their minds.
وإحنا كيف عرفنا إنه استشهد والدها لأنه البنت متغيرة عن ما كانت عليه يعني كانت هي تشارك كانت تتفاعل في الصف كانت تقوم تقعد تروح وتيجي يعني تتحدث مع صحباتها مع لما المعلمة تسأل تتجاوب ترفع إيدها، لكن حاليا صمت سكوت. لو جبنا سيرة الشهيد القصف الحرب الإشي على طول بيبين عليها، على طول بتعيط. فبتلاقي لسه الأطفال حالتهم يعني متوترة، لما تيجي تقرب عليه بتفكر انه بتلاقيه بفزد على طول هيك، يعني بتحس في انفعال. بعدين يعني حتى الان لسه مش متاقلمين على جو المدرسه، الامور البسيطه، امور بسيطه يعني في الدرس اللغه العربيه بتلاقيها نسياها.
Even those children not directly impacted by Israeli shelling have been traumatized. Trapped in their homes during the war, children were exposed to graphic images, including other children dying. All the kids here witnessed the deaths of the four children from the Dalut family, whose 12 members were killed when Israel bombed their home.
Israel claimed it warned family to flee the areas before it bombed through dropping leaflets and transmitting warnings over local radio and television stations. But many in Gaza found it even more terrorizing. Gaza is one of the most densely populated areas in the world. Gaza City is home to nearly three quarters of the population. Ragda Dirmendukh has moved her students to the Umm al-Qura after both her home and former school across the road were destroyed in bomb blasts. She explains it was also psychological warfare that had an impact.
منطقة تل الهوى لم ينزل أي منشور، لكن منطقة الشمال وبدوا الناس يتصلوا علينا على إنه جيش الدفاع الإسرائيلي بيطالب على إنه نرحل من المكان وننتقل لوسط البلد. رفضنا أوامرهم هذه لأنه كان كمان خوف على إنه ممكن يطلع من بيته الواحد ويقصف خلال طلوعه من بيته. مكان آمن بعيد عن المنطقة الخطرة أفضل من إنه يترك بيته.
Counselors say their students are desperate for their mothers. Some have not returned to school. The Ministry of Education estimates there are one or two clinically trained psychologists for every 1,000 students in Gaza's public schools. In the rural areas and within the poverty-stricken refugee camps, there are only school counselors. Teachers are working overtime, both as educators and training in school therapy to handle their students. Off camera, teachers tell us they too need counseling. According to mental health workers, recovering from the nightmare of war doesn't always happen, and when it does, it may take years depending on the age of impact. Doctors in Gaza say while Palestinian childhood for generations has been marred by war and trauma, Gaza's children are also under siege. They are now recovering from their second war in 4 years. Jahan Hafiz for The Real News, Gaza.